I've seen these around for the past 7 or so years. They used to cost around sort of $5 or so, but this one's quite a bit more expensive. It's around $20, and it's a 16-bit. So I believe this has almost 160 Sega games. So it comes with a composite cable. So in theory, we can hook this up to our TV and a micro USB charging cable. So here's the actual machine. Let's turn it on and see how well it works. So it does have 156 games. So I remember this game. I used to play this a lot. Golden Axe. Let's have a quick look. I think I put a lot of 10p's into this in the student union bar. I think we got to the point where we could actually finish it on just one credit. So I used to play the Dwarf. So I know the Sega port is surprisingly accurate compared to the arcade version. So I think I've still got the magic touch, or maybe not. But anyway, we're not here to play this game. Let's take this apart and see what's inside. So we'll turn that off. There is a volume control here. It's actually surprisingly loud. So let's turn it off and see how to open this up. So the battery compartment, let's unscrew this. So it does say on the box that there's a rechargeable, 600 milliamp hour rechargeable battery. So let's have a look. Screw doesn't want to come out. There we go. That's interesting. What an interesting battery. A1. Writing's quite small. Let's have a look. Rechargeable battery pack. It looks very much like the battery pack you used to get on phones. So that's kind of interesting. I wonder if there's a job lot of phone batteries left over from when you could still replace batteries in phones. So that's the battery removed. You can also power it from three AA batteries. Very handy. Let's get these screws out. Now, unfortunately, looking at how this is constructed, I think we're going to have to either peel this sticker back, or more likely we're going to have to cut into it, which is a bit of a shame. Let me get my X-Acto knife and we'll do that. It's a shame, as it would have been nice to keep this all in one piece, but I'm sure we can get it back together again. It just won't be quite as neat. So let's cut into here. That's that side, and do the same on the other side. And hopefully this will just come apart. Let's do a bit more chopping. And there we go, interesting. So looking here, we have the battery connector, speaker and the switch all going to this this main PCB, and then the USB is just on this little daughter circuit board. So let's take that, let's unscrew that, and we will unscrew this one. Interesting. Let's unscrew this one. I have a horrible feeling that we're going to find a blob chip under this, which is a bit of a shame. I was hoping for something that maybe we could do a bit of hacking with, but I feel like that might be unlikely. So I'm giving you a fantastic view of my hands here. Let's see, that lifts out quite easily along with the screen. Let's undo this so we can get this out as well. Very interesting. Right then, so does this come out now? So there's the screen, and I think so there's another screw here. Let's undo that as well. So that makes that come out. And then it looks like the controls stay in there. I think that's not screws in there. Yeah, a couple of screws. I wonder if we can leave the control panel in there and have a look at what's on the other side. Well, that's very interesting. So what have we got here then? There is a big IC on a little daughter board there. There is a blob chip. The display is just on a ribbon cable. Oh, we can actually detach that, so that's quite nice. Here's the volume control. Let's remove the display. Okay, that's the display removed. Put that somewhere safe. Let's get a close-up picture of this and see what's on the board. Should be quite interesting. It's a shame we don't know what's underneath this epoxy blob, but it is. Seems to be a pretty much a single-sided board. The only thing on this side is the crystal oscillator and a smoothing capacitor. Looks like there's space for another one there if we need it. So I'll get a photo of this and we'll see what chips there are. I think the control, yeah, there's some screws here that are going to be a bit of a pain to reach. So how they manage to screw those in themselves, actually. It's kind of interesting. I'm going to try and reach in there to undo a screw. Unless maybe there's a different way of taking this out, which I cannot fathom at the moment. Maybe this whole thing comes out. That's a possibility. Oh, there we go. The whole thing slides out. So that's interesting. We're going to have to ruin the sticker here. That's a shame. Let's snip that there. That's that side and that side. Okay, so this panel actually slides out. That's how we get to the screws. Let's just undo these screws and see what's underneath as well. So, well, that's not that exciting. It's just a simple membrane keyboard type thing. It is nicely labeled though, so that's good. X, Y, Z, A, B, C, and we've got a little joystick. And the labels are all here, so potentially there's a bit of potential reuse here. It is nicely labeled here. Let's get a photo and see if we can identify this big chip here and see what that is. That's probably the most interesting thing on the board. So let's have a look at that. I thought I'd power it up just to see, make sure it does actually work. And interestingly, we do have some little LEDs. I just didn't notice because my lights are so bright, but these do actually slot in here, and then this little arcade actually lights up. Let me turn down the lights so maybe you can see that. So there we go, it does light up with the little lights. So that's a nice little touch, isn't it? Anyway, let's get a photo and try and identify some of these chips.
But before we look at the PCBs, it's time for a quick plug for PCBWay. I've been using them for quite a long time now, and they're really great. I've got some PCBs with them right now. So check out the link to PCBWay in the description. They're really great to work with, and I recommend them.
So unfortunately, as expected, pretty much all the functionality is under this epoxy blob. This large chip is actually just a flash chip. What is quite interesting is the board is completely single-sided. So they've used this adapter board to basically take the flash chip and expose its pins in the right way to go through to the epoxy blob. So it's pretty interesting, but it's not very hackable. I wonder if they've used this daughter board so they can easily solder on different flash chips that are pre-programmed with different games, because there are a variety of different versions of this thing. So let's get it put back together and see if it still works. Hopefully the controls will still work. Which I suppose I could actually connect up everything and check that. Let's do that. That feels like a sensible thing to do, rather than put it all back together and then realise it doesn't work. So let's get the display back in place. Okay, I think that's the display in, so that's good. Got the battery in already. Let's power it up. Hey, that still works. Up and down works. Start. Any sound? Where's my sound? Oh, there we go. X-Men. Ah, then. Nice. Okay, start. Okay, yes, yes, yes. Yep. Oops, alright. Right. Oh, I think our buttons still work. Joystick seems to be doing something. Yep. Okay, that's good. And reset works. Great. Let's get it all back together. So this should slide back in nicely. There we go. It's like we never touched it. I think it's actually not too bad. You can barely see the cut marks and it still works. So, not very hackable, but pretty interesting nonetheless. I don't know what the copyright rules are on the games on here, but there's a lot of them. Yeah, interesting. Very interesting. There's a whole bunch of these in AliExpress, so yeah. I'm actually pretty impressed with it. Seems to work quite well. So, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.